po yung mga tanong ko kay Attorney Roque.
Yes, Madam Chair.
Yes, thank you. All right. So, Attorney Roque, incorporator rin po kayo, si Ms. Myla Roque, at ang dating law partner niyo, incorporators po kayo sa Biancham, tama po ba?
That is correct. Biancham is my family holding corporation.
All right.
It's part of our estate planning.
All right. So, family holding corporation, part of your estate planning. And then, ngayon, ang email address po sa cover sheet ng Articles of Incorporation ng Biancham. All right. So, verbally i-redact ko na lang, hindi ko na lang babanggitin yung email address. Isang observation sa kaninang pagtatanong, may layers ng ownership ang kumpanya, ng kumpanya ang bahay, pero lumalabas na kayo rin ito.
Well, I've never denied that, and that's why I said that I have an interest in that house. But it has to be emphasized. Now, for purposes of search warrants, they have to specify the registered owner ng bahay. Kaya nga po, una-una, dinideny ko po na na-raid yung bahay ko, ho, dahil wala pong search warrant doon sa nangyari. Ang meron lang po, mission order at pag-aresto ng Bureau of Immigration sa dalawang Chinese nationals.
So, mission order po ang nag-cover ng raid?
Hindi po raid.
Sorry.
Ang apprehension po. Kasi ang raid po, wala pong search warrant at may abogado naman po yung mga foreigners na nakatira ron, hindi po sila pinapasok because under the Constitution and the Bill of Rights apply also to foreigners, hindi po sila po pwedeng pumasok na walang search warrant.
Mm. Briefly, Attorney Roque, I'll leave you to just ask a related question sa BI. Mission order lamang daw ang dala at walang warrant. Can you educate a non- law enforcer like me?
Yes, Madam Chair. We confirm na during the arrest, the BI used the mission order. Wala pong search warrant. Walang warrant of arrest.
All right. So apprehended yung dalawang tao at nasa custody ngayon ng PAOK.
Yes, Madam Chair.
All right. Salamat po. Back to Attorney Roque. Can
yes,
I confirm?
Madam Chair.
Opo. Can I confirm lang po na your wife, Ms. Myla Roque, is the managing director of Biancham since 2015 ayon sa annual report ng Pag-ibig.
Well, she was with Pag-ibig and she was managing director of Biancham, but she resigned. She resigned.
When po?
I cannot remember exactly when, but as I said, we filed an application to be part of the AFAB property and we appended a feasibility study. Meron pong malicious report sa media making it appear na yun ang kinikita na namin. E yan po ay feasibility study. The requirement po yan ng AFAB kung kayo po ay mag-apply para maging kabahagi ng teritoryo ng AFAB. So dahil po doon, ayaw ng misis ko yung ganyang mga kontrobersiya, sabi po niya, I want out. At kaya nga po, ang nangyari po dyan, talagang nag-withdraw din kami dun sa project na yan because my wife said, I really want out. I want my privacy. No? At yan po ang dahilan kung bakit nagkaroon po ng change of ownership. At yan din po ang dahilan kung bakit recently, we are now taking moves to reclaim Biancham. No? Except that my wife really says, I want out. And that's also why we are contemplating even a separation of property para malinaw na hindi siya may involve sa aking mga business undertakings. The decision was made also because we had business reversals in a solar project kung saan dun ko po iniinganyo yung Whirlwind company, no? And we lost a substantial amount of money in that business transaction.
All right. Hanggang kailan managing partner yung asawa niyo sa Biancham?
Sandali lang po yan eh. Because yung investment po namin dyan sa First Bataan actually, and that was the controversy, was before I became congressman. And the controversy came out when I was a newly elected congressman, and that's when she wanted that's when she verbalized that she wanted out dahil ayaw niya.
Anong taon po yun nung naging rep
siguro
kayo?
Siguro 2016 po ako naging rep dahil so nanalo po ako nung 2016 elections.
So she would have been managing partner for at least 1 year from 2015 to 2016.
1 year lang po yan, hindi po nagtagal siya because she really wanted out. In fact, she wanted out of all my business transactions because gusto po niya maging pribadong individual.
All right. But gaya ng ipinakita kong articles of incorporation, list of incorporators kanina kay Mr. De La Serna, may incorporators na nakalagay doon, isa rin po si Ms. Myla Roque.
Yes, oh, that's right. What the document says po. Hindi po yan dinideny.
So just to summarize, yung house, all right. Okay, before I summarize, regarding yung pinaplano yung takeover sa Biancham, so ibig sabihin ba, bibilihin nyo yung shares ni AR? Bibili De La Serna? Bibilihin nyo yung shares ng ibang shareholders? Or kaninong shares or kani-kaninong shares ang bibili ninyo para ma-effect yung takeover?
Ang share po ni AR is one share. Ang tawag lang po dyan, qualifying. Kasi bago po naamindahan ang corporation code, kinakailangan meron lima na directors at limang incorporators. Ngayon po pwede na pong magkaroon ng one-man corporation. So kaya po yung mga nakalagay po dyan na one shareholder lamang, they are what is known as qualifying shares para makumpleto yung lima. Now, ang nangyari po kasi dyan is dahil we were also applying for an AFAB accreditation and at that time sa Kongreso po, nagkaring malaki issue yung pag-aari ni Congressman Florendo sa Tadeco, minabuti na rin po namin na lumabas muna doon sa investment sa Bataan. So nalugi po kami doon pero binalik ang pera namin na wala namang bawas, na wala lang kami ng interest. So yun po ang dahilan kung bakit nagbago po yung shareholdings ng Biancham, no? Pero ngayon po, as we speak, and even before this controversy, the papers are being drawn na babalik po ako, no? I'm going to repurchase the shares and I will register it soon, no? Dahil malinaw naman ang gusto mangyari ni Mrs. basta wala siyang kinalaman doon sa mga negosyo na pinapasok ko. So magiging malinaw ko anin sa kanya, anin sa akin, at para ang isusugal ko lang, to quote her words, is yung sa akin lang at hindi niya isusugal yung sa kanya at sa pamilya.
So, ibig sabihin po, i-buy out nyo sina Mr. De La Serna at yung iba pang shareholders para maging one-person corporation na yung Biancham sa inyo na po.
Well, actually, napirmahan na po nila lahat ang mga dokumento, no, papunta sa akin. Pero hindi pa po kami nagdonotaryo kasi inaayos pa, no. So, hindi naman po one-man corporation yan. Dahil sa totoo lang, kukuha rin po ako ng mga partners. So magkakaroon din po kami ng reallocation pero mangyayari po ay babalik talaga po ako dyan.
So just to summarize, yung bahay na naging subject ng mission order para ma-apprehend yung dalawang tao na associated sa Pogo Hub sa Bamban, that house is owned by PH2. PH2 is owned by Biancham, and your wife was managing director for about a year of Biancham.
Yes po.
All
yes.
Right. So we will just do more research on that.
And because yes, it is owned by PH2, Madam Chair, corporation under the laws approved by Congress have separate personalities from the individuals constituting the corporation.
Sige po. So those are my questions. No, sorry. So just to continue, Attorney Roque. So even after the testimonies of Chair Tenco and Attorney Fernandez, minimaintain nyo pa rin po ba na hindi kayo lawyer ng Lucky South 99 o kahit anong POGO for that matter?
I confirm that 100%. And the reason po is, dala-dala ko po ngayon ng mga dokumento. Alam nyo po, ang attorney-client relations, kinakailangan po yan magkasundo ang partido. because it is the highest fiduciary relationship. Kaya nga po yung tinatawag na attorney-client privilege, miski dito po sa Kongreso, hindi nyo mapapakontep kapag na-invoke yung attorney-client privilege. At sa totoo lang
within
po...
Within certain limitations, of course.
At sa totoo lang po, sana kinuha po ako ng lucky star na abogado. Bakit po? Dahil yung raid sa PORAP, unconstitutional po yan. Nag-raid po sila, kumuha sila ng warrant of arrest galing sa Bulacan judge outside of jurisdiction.
Excuse me, sige. Well, hindi natin ininvestiga ano yung raid. We are investigating
the Yes, ma'am, but I'm just saying.
So,
kasi,
please just make your answer to this short. Kasi yes. It was actually just a yes or no question.
Ma'am, but ma'am, let us be fair because you have been insinuating I am a lawyer for Lucky South. That is why...
Excuse me. The chair has not been insinuating anything. The chair and the members of the committee have been asking questions based on the testimonies, sworn testimonies of PAGCOR Chair Tengco, Attorney Fernandez of PAGCOR, and other resource persons. So the resource person will not impute any insinuation to the chair. Will please just answer the questions. The chair
okay.
has given the resource person
the, okay, Your Honor,
leeway
then,
to answer
in
the questions.
In the interest
so
of fairness, may I be allowed to dispute then the statement of the prior resource person?
We will get to that in the
okay,
course
so
of
the question again, Madam Chair, is
do you maintain na hindi kayo abogado ng Lucky South 99 or any POGO for that matter?
I maintain as an officer of the courts and under oath before the Senate of the Republic of the Philippines that I have never acted as legal counsel for Lucky South 99 or for any other POGO.
All right. Pero tama naman pong totoo na nakipag-meeting kayo sa PAGCOR tungkol sa POGO sa PORAC. Yes,
totoo po yun. Nakipag-meeting okay. ako. But as I said, ang aking kasama po ay kakilala ko bilang Whirlwind Corporate Secretary. And I have documents in my possession which I would like to submit now to the Senate.
Yes,
kasi iba po yung usap-usapan lang, iba kapag notaryadong dokumento.
Okay. And definitely, yung pagtestimonya ng ibang mga resource persons ay hindi rin lamang usap-usapan at may mga sinasubmit ding dokumento. Otherwise, the committee would not bother inviting them again and again to...
Madam...
Excuse me. I just like to ask the next question. So, ang topic ng mga meeting at pag-uusap nyo sa PAGCOR, and in fact, mga pag-follow-up nyo sa PAGCOR, ay utang ng Lucky South 99 ng mismong POGO. Tama po ba?
Tama po yun.
Alright, salamat. So, hindi lang talaga Whirlwind, Lucky South 99 din.
Pwede ba ho mag-explain?
Pwede naman po.
Okay, kasi po, ang Whirlwind is not only the lessor, they're also the service provider. Now, I appeal now to the... officials of PAGCOR, siguro kayo po mag-explain kung ano ginagawa ng service providers, including Chair Andre Dominguez, because I had an opportunity to
Domingo
work with her.
Po.
Domingo, no? Ang service providers po, sila talaga ang nagbibigay ng lahat na kinakailangan ng mga POGO operators, kasi POGO operators po, lahat yan Chino. Ni hindi po yan nag-i-Ingles. Kaya nga po, meron silang mga representative sa PAGCOR. Dahil sila mismo, they have no ability to communicate dahil nag-establish na nga sila ng mga independent POGO hubs. So ang pagkakaintindi ko po talaga, trabaho po ng service provider na magbigay ng serbisyo sa kanila mga kliyente.
All right, attorney, salamat. The committee will ask further questions sa PAGCOR. Balik na lang po tayo dito sa Lucky South at PAGCOR, no? Ang sabi po niyo, you did not authorize the use of your name in the organizational chart that was submitted as an official attachment by Lucky South 99 to PAGCOR.
Totoo.
So, kasalanan po yan ni Cassie Lin Ong, tama ba?
Hindi po. Kasalanan Hindi. Po yan ng kung sinong gumawa.
Sino
dahil wala
gumawa?
Naman pong establishment. Gumawa po niyan, Lucky South.
Yes.
Dahil sila po nag-a-apply.
Na si Cassie Lin Ong ang isang ano doon.
Wala po pa tayong ebidensya na nagpapakita kung sino nag-submit talaga ng mga dokumento, but PAGCOR can confirm kung sino talaga nag-submit ng mga dokumentong yan.
Okay, we will ask PAGCOR that again later. We asked them before. Basta ang malinaw po sa committee ay yung organizational chart na yan na may drawing, may box, na legal, na nandun yung pangalan nyo, was one of the official attachments sa submissions ng Lucky South 99 sa PAGCOR. And sabi nyo nga, yung obligasyon ng POGO sa ng POGO na Lucky Star sa PAGCOR ang pinag-uusapan ninyo sa PAGCOR. So, due diligence, bilang abogado dun sa mga diskusyong iyon, alam nyo kung ano yung mga dokumentong sinumite, alam nyo yung mga official attachments na nakalagay doon. Did you confront Cassie Lin Ong about this? Or kinasuhan nyo ba siya na kung bakit nandun yung pangalan nyo sa organizational chart?
Madam, nagagalit po kayo dahil sinasabi nyo binibigay ko ng mga salita ang inyong bibig. Pero right now, you already assume...
Hindi naman ako nagagalit. Sinasabi ko lang huwag nyong gawin
yun. Pero ngayon po, sinabi nyo, you again insinuated that I had anything to do with the document. Ayan nga pong sinasabi ko. As far as I know, attorney,
please stop using that offensive verb insinuating. I am a very plain speaker.
Okay,
pwede
I'm sorry.
Nyo lang, oh, it's all right. Pwede okay. Nyo lang sabihin mali yung fact na sinasite, tinatanggi nyo yung sinabi ng ibang resource person. Apat na taon na pong itong investigasyon. Halos wala na pong nag-i-insinuate kasi dire-diretso na pong mag-usap. Okay, so please tell the committee, kinonfront nyo ba si Cassie Lin Ong or kinasuan nyo ba siya bakit nandyan yung pangalan nyo sa organization?
Well, unang-una po, nalaman ko lang na nandun ang aking pangalan nung nag-hearing po last time dito na sinabi ni Chairman Altenco. Pero bilang abogado and naging professor ng constitutional law, I'm familiar with the rules of the Senate, and the Senate says that in proving facts, the rules of court apply in the supplementary character.
I don't need to argue with you about that, attorney.
Pero
but you don't need to...
Excuse me.
Sandali po. You don't need to tell the committee what the rules of the Senate are.
Well, I'm just citing
Please just po. Answer our question.
My answer po is that document is only evidence of its existence. Pero para patunayan po yung katotohanan na nakalasaad sa dokumentong yan, dapat meron pong testigo na nakakita ng ginawa yung dokumentong yan, o di naman kaya testigo ng gumawa ng dokumentong yan, o di naman kaya yung testigo na pumirma ng dokumentong yan.
Actually, as I said earlier, excuse me, Attorney Roque.
I'm sorry, madam, but
yes,
I am a resource
right.
person invited.
Yes, you are.
I was asked
Let me finish.
To answer.
Yes, you already answered in excess.
Kapag gusto niyo akong tumigil, papatigil niyo kapag ako nag-explain.
Yes.
I thought we were
Attorney.
Engaged in the search for the truth.
Oh, definitely we are. Attorney Roque, what I am saying, yes, and Sherwin.
Attorney Roque, please be reminded to respect the chairperson.
I'm very respectful, Madam Chair.
Paano respectful yung nagsasalita siya, sinasabayan mo siya?
I apologize, Senator Gachalian.
One more.
I apologize.
I will cite you in contempt. And if you disrespect the chairperson, we'll be compelled to cite you in contempt.
I understand and I apologize.
Kung naman sabayan siya, nagsasalita siya, siya ang chairperson.
Okay, Your Honor. I understand. I apologize.
Salamat, Sen. Sherwin. At salamat, Attorney Roque, sa apology niyo kay Sen. Sherwin. All I'm saying is, there is no need for any resource person to cite the rules of the Senate to a Senate committee. We know that. So please just answer the questions which are being asked of each resource person at length with an embarrassment of time para masagot nyo yung mga tanong. But please stick to the topics and do not lecture a Senate committee about the rules of the Senate committee. We know that. We correct ourselves kapag lumalabag kami doon. So, I suppose your answer is hindi kayo nagreklamo kay Cassie Lin Ong, Liong, at hindi nyo siya kinasuhan kung bakit nandun yung pangalan nyo sa chart.
As I said, madam, nalaman ko lang po yung pangalan ko nasa chart during the last hearing. Ang sinasabi ko po under oath as an officer of the court, hindi ko po inauthorize ang paglagay ng pangalan ko doon. Wala pong kinalaman sa paggawa ng dokumentong yan at wala pong kahit anong testimonya sa kahit sino na gumawa ng testimonya na nagsasabi na pumayag po ako. And I deny that under oath.
All right. And sa interview nyo naman po kina Ted Filon at DJ Chacha, inamin nyo, quote, dinulog sa akin yung problema ni Cassie yung nangyari sa Lucky South. So mula mismo sa bibig ninyo, interes ng mismong POGO ang meeting at fina-follow up nyo o inaareglo sa PAGCOR.
Kasi nga po, si Cassie ay service provider ng Lucky South. So gaya po ng sinagot din ni Dennis Cunanan, pag may problema ang Lucky South, tumatawag sila doon sa mga tao na tutulungan sila dahil hindi nga po nag-i-English yung mga yan.
Okay. So but, whether service provider o ano pa man, dinulog nyo yung problema ni Miss Cassie Liong at ng Lucky South na isang pogo, idinulog nyo sa PAGCOR.
Dinulog ko po dahil pinakiusapan po ako nung service provider. Dahil wala po akong kahit sinong kakilala sa Lucky South.